We've been getting so much festive season culinary inspiration over the last couple of days, but today we're switching it up a little bit. Annelle is going to show us how to make something a little fancier for the festive season. It's a beetroot gravache, wreath and caper gribiche. To us, it all sounds foreign. I don't even know what I'm saying. But to Annelle, it's a bit of heaven on a plate, I know for sure. But before we get started, I mean, Annelle, tell us, what on earth are these things? Why are we making them? Do they taste nice? Are you gonna love them? What's the story here?
Okay, it's gravala.
Yes.
Gravala.
Gravala.
And
that is cured fish, actually. So it's like we take a piece of salmon,
yeah,
and we're gonna cure it with salt and sugar and with beetroot today.
So basically like they used to do in the olden days.
Yes, to the olden days, to preserve things.
Yes,
to preserve
where there were no fridges.
Yes. Yes. Yeah. And you can also, instead of the beetroot, you can do some lemon, you can put some rum, you can put some dill, mint. Yeah, you can alles din wat jy lust is.
Karen, have you heard of this before?
No, this
before.
Is the first for me. I know the fish though,
yeah,
but the gravala.
The gravala.
And what the curing does, yeah, it makes the fish really waxy and beautiful. Ah. It takes this moisture out. So you can slice it in these beautiful thin slices. Mm. Otherwise, it can't be sliced so beautifully.
So that's how you do that to get these beautiful wreaths coming through. Okay.
Karen, if I can ask you to mix the curing mixture. So that's grated beetroot. That is salt. Yeah. We can put some salt in there.
All of it.
So salt goes into beetroot.
On his side, his bias side. Mm. And some sugar. If you can just mix that together.
Nice.
With a spoon. Yeah.
So who we don't know who feels salt and who feels suiker.
Yeah.
I say it's about 20% salt and then a bit sugar.
Okay.
But I will go half. Normally at home I go half, yeah, half sugar, half salt.
Yeah.
But check the recipe out. This one is a bit different.
Yeah.
But look at that already.
It looks lovely.
And you can always, if you're naughty, add a bit of vodka in there for like a bit of.
That's like what I might just do.
Especially on a Friday.
Yeah, or any day, really. If you have to wait for a Friday. But if Friday is the day, then that's fine. The keyword is Woolworths. SMS Woolworths to 33728 if you want us to send you an SMS with a link to the recipe to this. The recipe might not say vodka on it, but use your own discretion if that's what you want to do.
So what you do is you tap this onto your beautiful piece of fish.
Yeah.
And what I like to do, I wrap it then in cling film. I put it in the fridge for about an hour or 2 hours.
Okay.
So just let it cure for that amount of time.
Yeah. Okay.
They do say the perfect curing time is 5 hours.
Sure. Okay.
But it doesn't matter. And then you just take it off.
Okay.
All of that. I just want to take this away.
Okay. What can I help you with?
Come on.
You just take that away.
Okay.
Yeah. Mm. So that is going to be cured beautifully.
Yeah.
And now we're going to make the gribiche.
Mm. Gribiche, okay.
Gribiche is a French sauce. That's interesting because it's a Nordic dish with like a beautiful French sauce.
Mm. Yeah.
And this is fresh and it's exciting.
Yeah, the ingredients look really exciting.
Yeah. It's normally like a herb, a fresh herb, some cut gherkins, capers and caper berries and mustard. So we've got some mustard in here.
Yeah.
That. And we've got a bit of oil just to give it a bit of a consistency, the right consistency that we want.
To soften it as well.
Yeah. We're going to add some chopped gherkins. It gives that beautiful acidity to it and the crunchiness, guys. Because the fish is soft. You need that crunchiness.
What's that?
I'm going to tell you now.
Oh.
This is a bit of parsley.
Mm-hmm.
But you can replace the parsley like with dill or anything that you
really
enjoy.
So for someone who isn't really wild about parsley, you still do have some alternative herbs that you can use.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then this is capers that we've put in oil. We've just fried them. And it's like
that pop.
You've already tasted them.
Yeah. Look how beautiful that. And it's actually like, I'll call them caper popcorn.
Mm. Mm.
I'm going to add a little bit of this because I want some to use as a.
Also adds a nice crunch.
Yeah, adds a nice crunch.
Mm.
And that's that, guys. Mm. And then we can plate again. So
okay.
If you could give me that big plate.
This one, yes.
Yeah, because it's already in a beautiful wreath for Christmas.
Yeah.
It's beautiful.
It's stunning.
So
it looks like Christmas.
And
the
it looks so healthy. That obviously is.
And I like the beetroot, the color that it brings to the salad. Mm. Do you see that? It just gives it the edges.
So it's obviously going to give it a bit of taste and flavor, but it's also just going to enhance the aesthetic of it.
Exactly, exactly. Yeah.
So gravala is obviously a Nordic dish. It consists of raw salmon cured in salt, sugar, and dill. You can serve it as an appetizer. You can thinly slice it, accompanied by some
homeostasis.
Did I say that right? Homeostasis.
The fish. Or what are you saying? What are you saying?
No, don't ask me. A dill and a mustard sauce, either on bread. Or you can even have it with boiled potatoes as well, lovely. Which is really nice.
And the salmon is beautifully fresh from Woolworths. They've got beautiful fresh salmon at Woolies that you can use. And what's nice about this, if you've got, say, five or six people, a piece of 300 gram is more than enough for a starter platter.
Okay, because that's the thing, is you can use it as an appetizer, right?
Yeah, as an appetizer.
Yeah, I mean, you'd have to get lots of it if you wanted to really have it as a bit of a meal. Yeah. But it's really a treat, and it is about going a little bit the extra mile in terms of your meal for Christmas.
Yeah. So this is just actually like a upped version of sushi, guys.
It looks beautiful. It looks beautiful.
Doesn't it look lovely with a bit of this? And I would really like you guys to taste if you'd like to.
Yeah. Ah, stunning.
Okay. Yeah. Would you like to taste? And you said you're not a fish person, actually.
Yeah, and like she's already getting very excited about it. Well, this is a feast for your eyes, and it's of course delicious. It's light, as you can see, but it's also fresh. The perfect starter for Christmas. And now, thank you so much for showing us how to make this and teaching us something new. But of course, if you want some more festive inspiration, get your hands on the December issue of Taste Magazine. It is packed with all the goodness and all the absolutely inspired recipes that are going to be total crowd pleasers. Now, we've got some exciting news for you. We're giving away a 2,000 Rand Woolies voucher. How's that? If you want a chance to spoil your family with some Woolies Christmas favorites this year, enter the competition by filling in your online Woolies shopping basket with all of your favorite festive season treats. Take a screenshot of your basket items and let us know what you'll be serving up this festive season for, you know, your loved ones and why you're gonna be doing that. The competition will close tonight at midnight, and the terms and conditions can be found on our website, expressoshow.com. I'm gonna taste this.
Oh, you're gonna love it.
Oh yeah?
Oh yes.
The one. Balance is perfect. It's like salty, sweet, sour.
Woolworths 233728. We're gonna finish this.
That's beautiful. You take a break in the meantime. I think I'll have